In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet excluded values. Our directions are to state the excluded values for each. Now remember that in a fraction, the denominator cannot equal zero. So in order to find those excluded values, essentially, we're going to be solving for when the denominator equals zero. Because when we have zero in the denominator, that's undefined. So let's look at number one. In number one, an excluded value will be when 90k equals zero. So what we're going to do is divide both sides by 90 in order to solve for k. 90 divided by 90 is 1, so k equals 0 will make the denominator 0. Therefore, our excluded value in number 1 is 0. K can be anything but 0. And I just wrote 0 in set notation because some of these answers will have multiple excluded values. Moving on to number 2, we're going to solve for when n makes the denominator 0. So 6n minus 2 equals 0. If we add 2 to both sides, 6n equals 2. And then we'll divide by 6 to get that n equals 2/6, or simplifying to 1/3. So if n was equal to 1/3, you can see that if we plug 1/3 in for n, 6 times 1/3 is 2, and we would get 2 minus 2, which equals 0, in our denominator. And we cannot divide a number by 0. Therefore, n cannot be 1/3. So 1/3 is our excluded value in number 2. In number 3, 27x plus 27 cannot equal 0. If it equals 0, then that value for x is our excluded value. So we'll solve for when 27x plus 27 equals 0. Now I'm going to show you two separate ways to solve. First, let's solve this equation as is. So I'll subtract 27 from both sides to get that 27x equals negative 27. And when I divide by 27, I'll get that x is equal to a negative 1. So x cannot be negative 1 in number 3. Negative 1 is the excluded value. But look, let's go back to this original 27x plus 27 equals 0. I can start by pulling out a 27 from each of the terms in that binomial. So if I pull out a 27, I'll get x plus 1 equal to 0. So essentially factoring that, and you can see that x plus 1, if that's equal to 0, then 27 times 0 equals 0. So essentially, we're going to be solving for when x plus 1 equals 0, which we know is when x is negative 1. So that's just another way to think about number 3. Let's continue on to number 4. Right away, in number 4, there are no excluded values. That's because in our denominator, we have 63, and you can divide any quantity by 63. The only restriction or caveat for a fraction is that you cannot divide by 0, but there's no way that 63 will become 0 because it's not multiplied to a variable or an unknown. Therefore, there are no excluded values in number 4 because 63 will never equal 0. In number 5, we need to see when p minus 9 equals 0. And p minus 9 equals 0 when p is equal to a positive 9. Because if we add 9 to both sides, we'll have p remaining on the left-hand side, and 0 plus 9 is 9. So p cannot equal 9. That is the excluded value. In number 16, we're going to see when 14x squared minus 16x equals 0. However, at the start, I'm going to factor out an x. So rewriting this denominator, I'll have x times 14x minus 16. But note that I can pull out another term. Both 14 and 16 are even. So I can pull out a 2 from each of those. So now I'll have 2x on the outside, and then 7x minus 8. And we're going to see when that's equal to 0, because if this expression equals 0, then our number is undefined because we cannot divide by 0. Therefore, we're going to solve for x when this equation is equal to 0, and those will be our excluded values. So we need to see when 2 times x equals 0, and we're going to look for when 7x minus 8 equals 0, because remember, 0 times any quantity is 0, and vice versa. Any quantity times 0 is 0. So if 2x equals 0, 0 times 7x minus 8 equals 0, and if 7x minus 8 equals 0, 2x times 0 equals 0. Solving for when 2x equals 0, when we divide by 2, we'll get that x is equal to 0. So x cannot be 0. That is the excluded value. But we also have 7x minus 8, and we'll set that equal to 0. Adding 8 to both sides, we'll get 7x equal to a positive 8. And then when we divide by 7, we'll get that x equals 8 over 7. So our excluded values are 0 and 8 sevenths. So in set notation, one excluded value is 0 and the other is 8 sevenths. If we plug either of those in for x, we will get 0 in our denominator and we cannot divide by 0. In number 7, looking at our denominator, 5 minus a, if we set that equal to 0, then that a value we solve for will be our excluded value. So what I'll do here is I'll add a to both sides. When I add a to both sides, I'll get that 5 equals a positive a. Or you can think of this as a equals 5 if you want your variable on the left-hand side. So a cannot equal 5, so 5 is the excluded value. And if you were to plug 5 in for a, 5 minus 5 does indeed equal 0, and you cannot divide a quantity by 0. In number 8, looking at our denominator cannot equal 0. If it does equal 0, then when we solve, we'll get an excluded value. So 27r, set that equal to 0, dividing both sides by 27, we'll get that r is equal to 0. So in number 8, if r is 0, then our denominator will also be 0. Therefore, 0 is the excluded value. In number 9, we're looking for when 27n minus 54, when that equals 0, solving for n, we'll get an excluded value. So 27n minus 54 equals 0. I'll add 54 to both sides to get 27n on my left-hand side, and that's going to be equal to a positive 54 on my right-hand side. Now, my next step, I'll divide both sides by 27 to get that n is equal to 54 divided by 27, which is a positive 2. So if n equals 2, then our denominator will be equivalent to 0. Therefore, 2 is an excluded value. Now, on to number 10. X plus 10 cannot equal 0. If it does equal 0, when we solve for x, that will be an excluded value. So x plus 10, setting that equal to 0, we'll subtract 10 from both sides to get that x is equal to a negative 10. So in number 10, x equals negative 10 is the excluded value. And we cannot divide by a quantity of 0. I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll do the next 8 problems on this worksheet. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, or if you want to leave me a note, do that in the comments below as well. Before you continue on to the next video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.